Hey guys, I'm working out with Morgan. Today in this clip, we did back, started off with pull-ups. We did a variation of wide, regular pull-ups on assisted, and then we did a neutral grip, and then I believe we did a reverse grip. A lot of people neglect these and just say that pull-ups are the same thing as lat pull-downs, and they are not. You can definitely tell a difference. You can get some fat dude or some heavy dude who's able to pull a shitload of weight, sloppy or unsloppy, with good form on lat pull-downs, but I guarantee you, if he's heavy, he can't do a lot of pull-ups. So there's definitely a time and a place to do pull-ups. You should always try and incorporate them when you can.
I let the monies and the fools talk. I let the jewels and the hues talk. Watch face came with a fuse box. Chanel's on your bitch. The coupe is 320. The roof's hit or miss. Murder on the highway. The news is at 6. See, I did it my way. The proof's in the bricks. Yeah. Smell it through the Tupperware. Two can get you four like a double dare. I'm the king of the ovenware. You can piece the whole puzzle here. Niggas talking shit, yay, how do you respond?
Whoop, scoop, whoop, whoopie whoop. Am I too complex for complex con? Everything yay say cause a new debate. You see, he been out of touch, he cannot relate. His hard way too long, bitch too bad. Got a surrogate, his kid, get two dads. I be thinking, what would Tupac do? You be thinking, what new kids on the block do? If you ain't driving wild black, do they stop you? Well, MAGA hats let me slide like a drive-thru. That phone call from Ricky still hazy. When heaven got an angel named Avery. You gotta watch who you calling crazy. Yeezy, the newest billion-dollar baby. It won't feel right till I feel like Phil Knight. Going for 6 rings like what Phil told Mike. 7 pill nights, who know what that feel like? No more hiding the scars, I show them like Seal, right? How do you respond?
Okay, on these, this exercise on barbell rows, we really don't ever use a whole bunch of weight. You can do these either starting out or finishing with this movement. We don't ever use a lot of weight. You do use a lot of other muscles, like your glutes, your hamstrings, especially your hamstrings are already sore, it's gonna pull on your hamstrings a lot. Doing an overhand grip variation, so leaning over and pulling, it's gonna put a lot of stress on your lower back vertebrae. Already have issues with that. So that being said, we only started with a plate, added on 10 to 25 pounds extra, and just focused on the squeeze of these movements of 4 sets.
She had me dying now.
Okay, when I started recording this, we were talking about the the song that was just playing Meek Mill, Pusher T said on top 5, and all of them I'm dial on. If you watch Dave Chappelle, there's a skit that he did when he was a rapper. And he's like, oh, who are you top 5? He's being interviewed. He says, oh, I'm the greatest of all time. Think about it. Top 5 rappers of all time. Dial on. And he just counts off the top 5 of his favorite rappers. Of course, him being Dylan, he includes himself and he says he's the best. All time great. Pretty funny shit. So, with that being said, can't take everything too seriously. Gotta have a little bit of fun with it. So, on these exercises now, this was the third exercise we did. A lot of people want to reinvent the wheel or the book of what certain how things go, which is not bad, but a lot of time people can do that. They can't do certain moves that you can do, so the best ways to kind of get around that and keep things interesting is on these lat pull-downs here, and you'll see when I pan around here, when we get to Morgan's, what I'm explaining him to do is you're going to grab a normal grip with lat pull-downs, and you're staying upright for the first four sets, pulling to about your, about partial, yeah. So I think he has to go a little wider here. He adjusted his grip, but you're pulling all the way down, so a normal range of motion for the lat pulldowns, but you're staying upright as to where, you see how his back is pretty much upright as to where a normal person would do the lat pulldowns. They're normally arching their back a lot. Three movements on this lat pulldown machine. The first one, you're doing a regular range of motion from the top of the fully extended where my arm is here down to about your nose, but you're staying upright. And then the second part of the movement that you do after the first four sets of about 8 to 10, because I'm not using that heavy amount of weight, but I'm taking my time with the movement, getting a good stretch and a good contraction. Really squeezing your back, and you'll feel this all throughout your back. So what I'm doing here is I'm pausing for about 2 seconds along the partial range of the movement, and just squeezing as hard as I can. So then on the third part of the movement, the third set on this exercise,
you're gonna hit like a regular pull down,
or I should actually say for the last movement out of the three exercises that we're doing, the three variations of the movement that we're doing, Morgan's gonna go next after I go, as you can see right here in this video. And I believe he's doing the same. Yeah, so he's doing the same thing. So now you can see with this, you're still staying semi-upright, but you're kind of putting a little bit of arch in your back.
Hold about 2 seconds at the bottom, squeeze.
And you're just controlling the squeeze on this part of it, and you're gonna feel it a whole lot in your hands. Okay, sorry, so now that I'm getting further into this process, the first movement was just keeping your body upright, doing a full range of motion, just squeezing on top of your back, your traps, your rhomboids, and your lats. And the second part of the movement was to pull it down to a middle half of your upper back, so just squeeze. Get a lot of blood into your lats. Now that we moved on to the last part of the lat pulldown variation, you're doing a regular lat pulldown. So he's arching his back now, and he's actually coming down 4 inch of motion and squeezing. So you'll see he's actually bending more and using a tiny bit of momentum to get the weight that he has to move, squeeze, and you're gonna feel it all on your back. So, with this variation that we did, it's not really, it is included in the lat exercise, but this you want to kind of just get a narrower shoulder bar if you can. We just ended up doing it on this bar because I think the other bars were being taken or in use. So you're just shortening your grip, kind of doing like a pull up, and pretty much just squeezing, targeting your lats here. So you're not going all the way up, letting the bar come all the way up. You'll see me as I pull it down right here. It's a shorter grip than a regular lat pull down. Getting a stretch right at the beginning of the movement, and you're pulling it down, keeping your elbows tucked in, and it's gonna flare out. You can kind of see through my shirt, you're flaring out your lats a lot into this movement, and it's just to basically get the mid to upper part of your back on this movement.
All the ones, all the chains piled on the middle. All the dogs low key, right behind me in the Phantom. Never go, never go, dip on the set, stay Santana. Running back, turn the lights on when I hit up Green Lantern. Got a boss, run a dog down to Atlanta. In the cut, in the deep, so late, no, yeah, I might be.
Okay, just for video. We got a couple sets in just to kind of catch up on the video footage here. Usually I will do one straight set of this movement, and then I'll go and do the other variation of that. So what I mean by that is, you see how, well, you see incessant. Okay, so you see how I have the grip here on one side. I'm using one side at a time, so unilateral is what I'm doing right here. And I'm going with an underhand grip, pulling down right here. Usually I just do four to five sets of these run movements at a time, and then I will switch over to what Morgan does on the side here. But I think just for, you know, keeping things kind of fresh and not boring in a sense, I believe we kind of supersetted, and I think the max that we did was just a plate in 25. You're getting a good stretch on these. A lot of people like to just add multiple plates, like 2 to 3 plates, and just kind of move the weight, use a lot of momentum. Like, there's nothing technically wrong with that, but at the end of the day, you know, you're just moving weight to move weight, and you're not getting a pump or a contraction from that. You're not feeling the muscle. It's pretty useless. So I think we just warmed up with a few sets of those, a few reps, and then we actually added on, you know, weight, progressively pyramiding up, and just squeezing. So if you guys have a machine like this where you can kind of do a pull down here, it's a hammer strength row in the machine. And just do a variation of these if you can. So what this movement is doing, turning your body to the side like this, and just pulling down at an angle. It looks a bit awkward, but you kind of just have to play with it. And just get a feel for it. So it's a very short movement, but you are pulling, and this just focuses the lat. Specifically for the most part, so you get a good stretch the entire time you're doing these. So in this clip, I actually switched the next clip you'll see is a full range of movement on the rows. But in this variation that I take Morgan through, it's good to start off with these. You're using light weight, as you can see, and you're just short range of movement. You're squeezing all the blood into your lats. That's where most people would just throw on weight. Or just do manageable weight, as you can see here that I'm about to do, and just do regular rows. There's nothing wrong with the rows that I'm doing, but it's good to do it the variation that Morgan was just doing first, and then finish with these 400 movements on these cable bars. So again, guys, just go with the feel, do what you can. Again, just start off with pull-ups, into barbell rows, into three variations of lat pull-downs, into a hammer strength rowing machine. Again, just go with the feel there, do what you can, just play with the machines. A lot of it's not rocket science, but a lot of people just neglect to do these things. Stretch after every movement that you do. And then again, try these rows you're going, hitting on your lats for the first few sets of these to squeeze the blood into your lats, and then go ahead and proceed to do a full range of motion with these cables. And hope you enjoy it.